The thousand-year-old tradition of the Kabbalah, imparted by revelation, has been handed down over the centuries to meet the spiritual and cultural needs of each moment in history. Now, we find its fundamental principles in the arts, science, and modern psychology. The purpose of this exhibition is to present the fundamental principles of this tradition and to share the experiences of my inner worlds. In them, I try to communicate the multidimensional nature of ourself and the transformative and evolutionary potential of our consciousness. Who are we? Where do we come from? What is life? Why do we incarnate? The oral tradition of the Kabbalah states that the reason of existence is that God, the absolute, the transcendent, the undefinable, wished to behold God. For that, he created a void to manifest his attributes. This emptiness is the mirror of his creation. And with this utterance, I will be many, invited us to participate in his creation. And separated light from darkness, and his spirit hovered over the waters. When God finished his work, he saw that everything was good and commanded all the laws, visible and invisible, that would govern the universe and invited us to participate in this great plan. Everything comes from the unlimited light of the Creator. This explosion of light will give life to humanity. We are His image and His most perfect creation. Before anything existed, we were in the mind of God. Male and female created us, soulmates, the spirit of the human species. When we descended to paradise, our androgynous spirit took form, dividing itself into a male and a female soul, gave us faculties only human beings have, the power to choose. We chose to incarnate, to experience soul through our senses, and to acquire the knowledge only life can give us. And with that, the opportunity to learn how to develop our real selves. God, in His infinite love, put us in the right plane to evolve and gave us a human body, the most perfect piece of engineering. Following the pattern of the Tree of Life, which contains all the laws of creation, we descended into matter. As a simple crystal of DNA, where all life begins, which contains the full and unknown potential of a human being. Wisdom manifests itself as an expansion of energy without limit, as an indiscriminate explosion of sperm. This will be received by an ovary to give form to the organic organization of the DNA. This is how life is understood, as the dance of the chromosomes which mirror the image of the divine. Only God will allow us to exist. His voice calls us to follow with the process of our gestation. Ourselves will define themselves for the correct development of our organism. Under her merciful and penetrating gaze. And the rigorous judgment of his divine understanding, which will balance our metabolic and emotional worlds. Under the scrutiny of the eye of God, divinity is attracted into matter to keep the essence of our being, the perfect image of I am. From the central axis of the light of divine consciousness flows a constant dew that falls from heaven. The archangels of mercy, which are the manifestations of God's actions, carefully monitor the vital functions of our being. Meanwhile, the archangels of his judgment maintain, with great care, the genetic code of this particular being. The luminous hands of the providence of God sustained our image, giving us the gifts and talents we need for the purpose of our life. When we incarnate, oblivious of the divine hidden existence contained in the pattern of the Tree of Life, we forget. Reaching maturity, we will have the choice to take the next step and in full consciousness return to the loving embrace of God. The only permanent human feature contained in every human being is the knowledge of the Tree of Life. We are the image of God, a spark of His light. During the process of our gestation, the eye of God follows the construction of our body. Meanwhile, our soul goes through a radical transformation. We incarnate to perform certain tasks and to learn certain lessons in order to fulfill the divine plan of creation. From the beginning of time through eternity, God invited us to participate in His divine plan to experience the infinite aspects of existence. Our destiny will be formed through many lifetimes, so to be able to fulfill the purpose of our mission. In between lives, we wait at the treasure house of souls, planning our next incarnation. Our guides, who are discarnate human beings that in previous lives acquired their wisdom, will sustain deep conversations with us about who will be our family, about our group of working souls, and about the place and the historic time more adequate for our development. If we just could remember all this, our understanding of our life events will be very different. But being born, immersed in matter, we forget. At birth, when our soul is incarnating in our body, our guides are present, taking care that no evil spirit can hurt us. The whole potential of our consciousness will be temporarily hidden in the very essence of our being. When we emerge out from the cosmic matrix and the eye of the will of God, a pair of hands received us in this world, and in that moment we cry, I am. Our guardian angel will accompany us along the several stages of our journey in order to guide and help us to fulfill our purpose in this lifetime. During the first years of our life, we still are very connected with the higher worlds and with our inner fantasies full of gnomes, fairies, and myths. Life is a self-discovery journey through our senses. We live our experiences and learn about emotions while our body slowly develops. Hidden in the deepest part of our consciousness lies the staff of our inner knowledge, acquired in the higher worlds and in the experiences of our previous lives. Around 7 years old, our mind will start to develop. We will have to learn how to read and write and the customs of our community to become part of it. Meanwhile, we develop a persona. Hormonal changes start manifesting in our bodies. Passions and powerful friendship attachments intensify. The participation in the physical world and the position in our community increases. Our vegetable soul will have to propagate, looking for a place in the society. The soul, at 21 years of age, flourishes and we'll have to start transmitting what we have received. We start to experiment our first awakenings, though it doesn't happen in all cases. We will remember who we are, and hopefully the mission we planned in the higher worlds for this lifetime. As long as we recover our true identity, we explore the inner content of emotions, perceiving that it could be something beyond this life. For the first time, we will listen to the call. This is the voice of our inner teacher who is I Am. We can answer, I do not have time now. I have other more important things to do. But if the answer is yes, we will have to make the decision to develop our full potential and to embrace the totality of our being. There is not a path. We will have to trace it. For that reason, we take back the staff of our inner knowledge and walk naked, dressed with light, while invisible presences guide us. We will meet new companions who, like us, walk to the light. Every day is a new day. Every day, we will have to purify the past and living in the present, opening new doors for the future. Hopefully, when we reach the autumn of our lives, we will know how to love generously without making vain judgments, and reaping the harvest will impart what we have learned. Moments of happiness, abundance and love, wealth and inner celebration of life. Many will be in agreement with this experience, but many others will realize that still there is a lot to learn and experiment. When we realize how ephemeral life is and how scarce the value of material things are, we decide to explore a new and deeper dimension of our being. To think about our own death makes us feel dismembered. It is painful and difficult to let go the idea we have about ourselves, because it is something we always thought we were. We will touch very profound areas of our unconscious. The dark night of the soul, indeed, a very powerful initiation. Within such a solitary pondering, in awe, we sense the light of our inner self. When we come back from this mysterious abyss, foreigners to ourselves, we will never be afraid of death. And with this deep experience, we realize that I am who I am. It is always me and my own image. This experience is a very powerful understanding about the meaning of our life. On discovering who we are, we surrender to the Holy One, putting aside the last trace of our identity, and following the infinite light that guided us along our journey, we pronounce, "Because you are, I am." Death is not a departure, because we will have to return. At death, the veil that separated us from the higher worlds vanishes. After living a life in full consciousness, when we finish our mission for this incarnation, our soul returns to the cosmic matrix. The last vestige of individuality disappears to merge with its creator, ending the mission given to us for this incarnation. And we listen to a voice that says, "You can never get lost, because when have you been separated from me? You and I are a continuity of the eternal consciousness."